Sairam students, today we shall discuss about lines and angles. First, let us learn some important definitions in lines and angles. Line segment. It is a part or portion of a line with two endpoints. So, line segment will have two endpoints. And it is a part or portion of a line. Then ray. What is meant by a ray? It is a part of a line with one endpoint. So if a line has got only one endpoint, then it is known as a ray. Then what is a line? It is that which has no endpoint. Okay. It will not have any endpoints. It means it extends indefinitely in both the directions. Plane. You should know what is a plane. It is a flat surface that extends indefinitely in all the directions. Some examples are blackboard, the surface of the table, walls of a room, etc. Some more definitions. Collinear points. When three or more points are lying on the same line. Now look at the points A, B and C. They are lying on the same line, then we call them as collinear points. Suppose they are not lying on the same line, it means they are lying outside the line. For example, instead of B lying here, if the point B is lying here, then they are said to be non-collinear. But here, all the three points are lying on the same line, so it is known as collinear points. Next, intersecting lines. If any two distinct lines or meeting at a common point, then they are known as intersecting lines. Here, the lines A, B and CD, they are having a common point, meeting at a common point O. So, they are known as intersecting lines. Next, you should know what is meant by an angle. An angle is formed when two rays originate from the same endpoint. Look at the diagram. We have two rays, namely OA and OB. Already we have seen what is a ray, right? Now you have got two rays, OA and OB. Both of them meet at a common point, okay? And they are originating from that same point O. Then we call that as an angle. Again, I repeat, angle is formed when two rays, here the two rays are OA and OB, when they originate from the same endpoint O here. Now, the two rays which are making an angle, we call them as arms of the angle. So, here OA and OB are the two arms of the angle and O is known as the vertex of the angle AOB. Next, concurrent lengths. If suppose three or more lines, they are going to intersect in one common point only, then they are called as concurrent lines. Now look at the figure drawn. You have so many lines. You can name the line as AB, CD, EF, GH and so on. You can draw like this so many number of lines. If they are all intersecting at the same point, the common point, say O, then all these lines are said to be concurrent lines. Next, we shall discuss about some important types of angles. We have different types of angles. Let us learn one after another. Acute angle. What is an acute angle? If an angle is less than 90 degrees, less than 90 degrees means it can be 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 58 degrees, like that. So, whenever the angle made by the two rays is going to be less than 90 degrees, we call that as an acute angle. Obtuse angle. If the angle is greater than 90 degrees, but it should be less than 180 degrees. So, examples of obtuse angle, it can be like 100, 125, 179, like that. So, the condition is for an obtuse angle, it has to be greater than 90 degrees but lesser than 180 degrees. Next, what are complementary angles? Suppose a pair of angles form a sum which is equal to 90 degree, then we call them as complementary angles. It should be a pair of angles. I repeat again, a pair of angles whose sum is 90 degree. For example, let me take 30 degree and 60 degree. This is a pair of angles, 30 degree and 60 degree. What is their sum? 30 plus 60 will be 90 degree. So we say this angle, namely 30 degree and 60 degree, form a complementary angles. Next, what are supplementary angles? Here, the pair of angles sum should be equal to 180 degree. Again, you can give your own examples. Numerous examples are there. You can give anything, but the condition is the pair of angles sum should be equal to 180 degree. For example, 110 degree. And what will be the other angle? If the sum has to be 80 degree, the other angle is going to be 70 degree. Similarly, you can think of other example also. So if it is 172 is one angle in that pair of supplementary angle, then the other angle is going to be 8 degree. Now, obviously, their sum is 180 degree. So we say this pair, namely 172 degree and 8 degrees, form supplementary angles. Next, what are adjacent angles? The pair of angles are said to be adjacent if they have a common arm and they will have a common vertex, and if the non-common arms are lying on the either side of the common arm. So three conditions has to be satisfied for an angle to be adjacent. What is that? First condition is they should have a common arm. Look at the diagram. Look at the diagram. These angles is a pair of angles O, AOB, BOC. Look at this pair of angles AOB and BOC. They have a common arm. What is a common arm? OB is the common arm. They should have a common vertex. Common vertex means the meeting point should be the same. What is the common meeting point? O. They have a common vertex. And the non-common arms. What are the non-common arms here? Only OB is a common arm, means OA and OC are going to be non-common arms. So they are lying on the either side of the common arm. I hope it's clear. So three conditions have to be met if the angles are to be adjacent. So the conditions are, first, it should have a common arm. They should have a common vertex. And the non-common arms should be on the either side of the common arm. So, it's clearly illustrated in the diagram as well. Next, we shall learn some properties on adjacent angles. The first property is, if a ray stands on the line, then the sum of the two adjacent angles so formed will be equal to 180 degree. Now, look at this particular diagram. OC is a ray which is standing on the line segment AB. So, when we have such a situation, here the sum of the two adjacent angles, what are the two adjacent angles? AOC and COB. This forms a pair of adjacent angles. Their sum will be equal to 180 degree. Why they are adjacent angles? Already we have discussed what are adjacent angles. They should have a common arm. Common arm is OC. And they show a common vertex. O is the common vertex. And the non-common arms, namely OA and OB, are on the either side of the common arm, OC. That's why AOC and COB, they are said to be adjacent angles. Now, in this property, it clearly states, when the ray stands on the line segment AB, then the sum of the two adjacent angles equals 180 degree. That is, angle AOC, here angle AOC plus COB should be equal to 180 degrees. Linear pair. Adjacent angles are said to form a linear pair of angles if the non-common arms are in the same straight line. So again, linear pair, what is the condition? It should be an adjacent angle. Initially, it should be an adjacent angle. and adjacent angles will be forming a linear pair when it will form if the non-common arms. Obviously, from the diagram you can see OA is the common arm, OB and OC are the non-common arms. Here the non-common arms, if you look at them, they are in the same straight line. Can you observe that? BOC, that is a line. So, whenever the non-common arms are in the same straight line, then we say that the adjacent angles form a linear pair. So, obviously here AOB and AOC, they form a linear pair of angles. Suppose in this diagram, if OC, instead of drawing like this, suppose if it is like here, suppose OC here, it will not be a linear pair. Are you getting, children? It will not be a linear pair of angles. Of course, it will be adjacent angles. Okay, in that scenario, it is going to be adjacent angle, but it will fail to be a linear pair. So, what is the important criteria for the adjacent angles to be linear pair? It should, the non-common arms should be in a same straight line. That's the important condition you need to remember. Vertically opposite angles property. Now, let us consider two straight lines, AD and BC. Here, when they are intersecting each other at a common point O, then you are having two pairs of opposite angles, AOB, COD, this forms one pair, and the other pair is AOC, BOD, this is another pair. That's what I mentioned clearly. So, they are said to form a pair of vertically opposite angles, right? And also you should remember that whenever two intersecting lines are like what I have shown in the diagram, then the vertically opposite angles will always be equal. For example, here it is 95 degrees. Here also it is going to be 95 degrees. Are you clear, children? The vertically opposite angles should be equal. Is the criteria to remember. Next, we shall see what is meant by a transversal. A line which intersects two or more lines at distinct points is called as transversal. Now, look at the diagram. You have two lines AB and CD, and there is another line which we call it as EF. So, this is intersecting the previous two lines AB and CD at some distinct points, say P and Q, right? So now, here, when such an intersection happens, you have eight angles formed. You have eight angles formed. So the angles are marked very clearly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So here, the angles 1 and 5, it forms a pair of corresponding angles. Similarly, 2 and 6 is another pair of corresponding angle. 3 and 7, the third set of corresponding angles. 4 and 8 are the fourth set of corresponding angles. That's what is clearly mentioned here. Next, you should know what are interior angles. Among these 8 angles, there are 4 interior angles. Interior means which is formed inside. Okay. In between 2 lines. So, here the interior angles are 3, 4, 5 and 6. They are the interior angles. And there are alternate angles also, namely 3, 6. Okay. 3 and 6, it forms a pair of alternate angles. Also, 4 and 5 form a pair of alternate angles. So, what do you understand by a transversal? Whenever a line, it is going to intersect any two distinct lines at a distinct points, then that particular line we call it as a transversal. Now we shall see some angle properties if the transversal is going to cut the given parallel lines. When a transversal intersects two parallel lines, so here CD is a transversal. Let us mark these lines as AB and PQ. So, when a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then what happens? Each pair of corresponding angles are equal. We have already seen what are corresponding angles. So each pair, there are altogether four pairs of corresponding angles, which we have already seen. So each of them will be equal. For instance, angle 1 will be equal to angle 5. That is, a pair of corresponding angles, they will be equal to one another. Similarly, angle 2 will be equal to angle 6, angle 3 equals angle 7, and angle 4 will be equal to angle 8. So each of the pair of corresponding angles are going to be equal. That is the first statement. Look at the second one. So when again a transversal is going to intersect two parallel lines, what will happen? Each pair of alternate angles are equal. You already know what are the alternate angles. Angle 3 now will be equal to angle 6. Each of the pair will be equal. That's what the rule states. Similarly, angle 4 will be equal to angle 5. Then the last one. Each pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal will be supplementary. Already you know what are the interior angles. Angle 3, 4, 5 and 6. These are the interior angles. Each pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal. You know this is a transversal. Right? This is a transversal. So which are the angles on the same side? 3 and 5. Right? 3 and 5 are on the same side, their sum will be supplementary. Supplementary means what? It's going to be 180 degree. Similarly, which is other pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal? It is going to be angle 4 and angle 6. Their sum is also going to be 180 degree. Next. Let us take some numerical problems based on what sir we have discussed. In the given figure AB and CD, okay, AB and CD intersect at the point O. You have to find angle COB. Angle COB, this angle we have to find. We are going to make use of the property that we have learned. So, when a ray stands on the line segment, the sum of the adjacent angle is going to be 180 degree. So, this is a ray, DO is a ray standing on the line segment AB, which means AOD and DOB are going to be adjacent angles. So, this angle AOD, angle AOD is going to be 180 minus 72 degrees. So 180 minus 72 is going to be 108 degrees. This angle is 108 degrees. Already we have again seen that the vertically opposite angles are going to be same. Here CD and AB, when they are intersecting at the point O, we are getting the vertically opposite angles. So this angle is going to be 108. And opposite to this, this angle is going to be 72 degrees. Now, we are asked to find only angle COB. So, where is COB? This one. Angle COB is going to be 180 degrees. Next, the given figure AB is a straight line. Find X. Again, using the same principle, here the ray OC stands on the line segment AB. Obviously, the sum of the two adjacent angles so formed will be equal to 180 degree. Here, AOC and COB are the pair of adjacent angles. Their sum should be 180 degree, which means 5x plus 10 plus 5x. This value should be 180 degrees. So now we'll group all the x terms, 5x and 5x. That will be 10x. 10x plus 10 equals 180 degree, which means 10x will be 180 minus 10, that is 170. So the value of x is going to be 170 divided by 10, which is 17 degrees. So this is the value of x. Next, look at the given figure. The line P is parallel to the line Q. We need to find the angles 1 to 7. The numberings are given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These are the numberings given. Of course, this angle is 70 degree. Right? So, what will be angle 2? They are forming the vertically opposite angles. We will just name the lines. So, let us take this as A. This as B. This meeting point as P. Or we will take something else. Already P and Q is there. So, we will take this as O and this as O dash, something like this, right? And this also will give some D, something like that. So, now find angles 1 to 7. This is 70 degree angle AO. Angle AOP is 70 degree. 2 is vertically opposite to 70 degree. So angle 2 is going to be 70 degrees. They are vertically opposite angles. What will be angle 1? Now OA, O dash A is a ray standing on the line segment DP. So angle 1 is going to be 180 minus 70. Using the adjacent angle property, is going to be 180 minus 70, that is 110 degrees. Okay, 2 we have found, 1 also we have found. What will be 3? 3 will be, they are vertically opposite angle. 1 and 3 are vertically opposite angles, right? So, 1 will be the same as angle 3. Next, coming to these four angles, angle 2 plus angle 4, these are the interior angles. As you observe, angle 2 and angle 4, they are the interior angles on the same side of the transversal. By the property of transversals which you have seen in the last slide, their sum should be equal to 180 degree. Angle 2, already we know that value is 70 degree. So if angle 2 plus 4 is going to form supplementary angles, that's 180 degree. So obviously angle 2 is 70 degree plus angle 4, this is going to be 180 degree, which means angle 4 is going to be 180 minus 70, that's 110 degree. So obviously angle 4 will be equal to angle 6, correct? Because both are vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. How about angle 5? Same principle. Angle 3 and 5, they are the interior angles on the same side of the transversal. So angle 3 plus angle 5, this will be equal to 180 degree. They will form supplementary pair. Angle 3 value is the same as angle 1, which is 110. Plus angle 5 will be 180 degree. So that implies angle 5 to be 180 minus 110, which is 70 degree. So once we know angle 5, 7 is going to be vertically opposite to angle 5. So that also will be angle same value. Angle 7. So we have found all the angles 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6. What will be 6? 6 is the same as angle 4 because they both are vertically opposite angles. So, just by knowing one angle, we are able to find the remaining all the angles. Now you can take some assignment problems based on what sir we have done. The given figure, find y if x equals 42 degrees. So this is the diagram. Look at the second question. Say true or false. A line segment extends to infinity on both its sides. Is it true or false? Second one. The two distinct lines in a plane may either be intersecting or parallel. The third question. Again, look at the given diagram. Here P, Q and R are parallel lines intersected by a transversal. You can clearly see it in the diagram. P, Q and R are the three lines and it is intersected by the transversal M. You need to find the angles 1 and 2 respectively. This angle alone is going to be 48 degree. So you need to find angles 1 and 2 respectively. Sairam students.